writer, the, I think it was of the Song of Solomon. No, it wasn't the Song of Solomon. It was one of the writers that said, "It is of the Lord's mercy that we are not consumed, because his compassions, lamentations it is, thank you, that we are not consumed because his compassions, they fail not. They're new every morning. Great is his faithfulness." So it is the Lord that has certainly blessed us tonight and given us the wherewithal to help us to make it thus far by faith. With an old song that we used to sing, "We've come this far by faith, leaning on the Lord." Can the church say amen? I want to take your time. I want to call your attention to two places tonight in your Bible, if you'd be so kind. If you can get in your hands the book of Exodus, chapter number 28, and we're interested in verses numbers 1 through 4, and also get in your hand Ephesians chapter number 6, starting with verses numbers 13 tonight. If you can get those two particular places in your hand, I'm going to try to do something a little different tonight. I don't know what the Holy Ghost is going to do, but I'm going to try to be a little less dogmatic, if you please. Can the church say amen? Let's read here. It says, "And take thou unto thee Aaron thy brother and his sons with him, from among the children of Israel, that he may minister unto me in the priest's office, even Aaron, Nadab, Abihu, Eleazar, Ithamar, Aaron's sons, that thou may make holy garments for Aaron thy brother, for glory and for beauty. That thou shalt speak unto all that are wise hearted, whom I have filled with the spirit of wisdom, that they may make Aaron's garments to consecrate him, that he may minister unto me in the priest's office. These are the garments which they shall make: a breastplate, an ephod, and a robe, and a broidered coat, a mitre, and a girdle. And they shall make holy garments for Aaron thy brother and his sons, that they may minister unto me in the office of the priests." Let's go now to the New Testament, and let's read in Ephesians chapter number 6, and we're interested in starting with verses numbers 13. Can the church say amen? Amen. "Wherefore take unto you the whole arm of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all to stand. Stand therefore, having your garments girded about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God." In the church, say amen. Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you, my God, for your goodness. Lord, tonight we bless you, Lord, for you and you alone are faithful, worthy to be praised. Lord, speak to us. Help us, oh God, to be all that you would have us to be, oh God. Help us to walk with you and to love you. In the evil day that we are in, my God, to walk according to your will. Let the Holy Spirit, oh God, be our lead and our guide. Amen. Throughout, my God, this crooked and perverse generation, my God, but you are with your children, oh God. You are, my God, the captain of the Lord's host. Father, you are everything that we need. Let thy will be done, O God, tonight. We give you the glory and we bless you in Jesus' name. And let the church say amen and amen. Praise the Lord tonight. We certainly thank the Lord tonight for these words that have been read in our hearing. The word is already blessed. Amen. And it is wonderful. Can the church say amen? Amen. I want to talk to us tonight from this thought. The fight is on. Amen. The fight is on. The fight that we, of course, are referring to here is the fight that pertains to the end of the finality of our walk with God, and that is the fight for our faith. We have read in two particular places tonight that refers to the same thing, refers to the girding of the priests and saints, those that have the office of the priesthood. And so the reason why I chose to call your attention to these two particular places, because they in many respects are synonymous. And so it is in the natural, so it is in also, Brother Bobby, in the spiritual, inasmuch as the various things that God in many cases did in the Old Testament was a example unto us. In fact, Paul writes in one place in the book of 1 Corinthians, I believe in chapter number 10, yes, he speaks along this line that these things were done unto us or them for our example and our admonition, upon whom the ends of the world have come, speaking unto his acts that he performed in the land of Israel and among the children of Israel. The things that God did was an example to us who were the fulfillment of the type that he was no doubt trying to saints to make known unto the children to come. And so it is important for us to understand that the garments, Elder Tweedale, that the priests wore was a type of the various spiritual garments that we put on today that help us fight against the wiles of the enemy. In fact, he even says in this particular book here, in the sixth chapter, which we did not read, he said, "Finally, brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil." And so what God was doing, saints, when the priests, amen, were girding themselves as they went into the tabernacle to serve the Lord, those garments, as we read, were for beauty and they were for holiness. And they were to show the righteousness of God. They were to show the power of God. One of the most beautiful places that ever existed on the earth was in the realm of service within the tabernacle. As I've said before, when you looked at the tabernacle from an outward appearance, it did not look like it was beautiful. Amen. But the various materials that God used to, amen, furnish, praise the Lord, the articles of worship, praise the Lord, that was used, amen, to work, amen, the work of God and the system of worship that he had put in the earth were wonderful. Can the church say amen? If you've ever seen a picture of the replica of the high priest in his garb, amen, it was a beautiful sight to see. It was, as it were, the beauty of God, amen, that was shining out of the church. Can the church say amen? And so these two particular places in your Bible are intertwined from this respect, amen, that what they did in the Old Testament was a fulfillment, amen, brothers and sisters, of what we do in the New Testament. Except what they did in the, amen, in the Old Testament, in the tabernacle, was simply, saints, it was a type, amen, it was a foreshadowing, it was a pattern, a figure, praise God, of things to come, amen, that God wanted to do when we got here. And I want you to know, people, whether they know it or not, we are fighting today, saints. We are fighting, amen, to keep our faith alive. We are fighting, praise the Lord, to hold our integrity. We are fighting, amen, against the onslaught of the enemy that tries to, amen, come against our mind, come against our psyche, and get, amen, ourselves all miscombobulated. Can the church say amen? So Paul understood that. He understood that these things were significant to us. Amen. So he tells us, finally, brethren, amen, be strong in the Lord. Praise the Lord, and in the power of his might. It's not our might, praise the Lord, that is going to help us overcome, but it's our, amen, desire to allow the word of God to attach itself, praise the Lord, to our spirit, to attach itself, saints, to our mind, because we are in a fight whether we know it or not. Praise the Lord, and the fight is real. Can the church say amen? We're going to need some tools, praise the Lord, in this particular fight that we are in, amen, to keep our mind, praise the Lord, to keep our spirit man in contact with God. Can the church say amen? We need God to help us, amen, because the enemy is trying to infiltrate our defenses, amen. So when you see, hallelujah, these things that are going on in the world, the Bible said in one place, we should look up because our redemption draw nigh. But as long as we are in this world, saints, brothers and sisters, we are going to have to learn how to fight. We're going to have to learn, thank you, Holy Ghost, how to, amen, hallelujah, put up our duke spiritually, if you please, praise the Lord, and fight ourselves out of situations, hallelujah, through the baptism of the Holy Spirit, praise God, through our faith in God. And all of these things were done, amen, for an example to us, to show us that we can do it. Can the church say amen? When they walked into, as it were, from a natural standpoint, when they walked, praise God, into the tabernacle in the Old Testament, the temple, praise the Lord, they were supposed to see the power of God as the priest was operating in the unction, amen, and in the order of God that he had given them when Aaron was working within, amen, the confines, hallelujah, of the church, amen, or the confines of the tabernacle, if you please. It was so they can see the beauty of God. And that's the same thing that should be happening today, amen, as we walk in the spirit, amen, having all of these garments spiritually over us, praise the Lord, so that, hallelujah, the world can see that there is a God. Praise the Lord. There is somebody that loves Jesus. And as I've said before, amen, there's nothing, brothers and sisters, that everybody's doing. Amen. There's nothing that everybody's getting themselves involved in. Praise the Lord. There is somebody that's living holy. Praise the Lord. There is somebody that loves Jesus. And the church say amen. There is somebody, hallelujah, that's going to have their lamps trimmed and burning. There is somebody that's going to walk with God. There is somebody that is going to do it God's way. Can the church say amen? Amen. So he tells us finally, or the conclusion of everything, amen, is that we have to be strong, praise the Lord. Amen. Not in our power, not in our might, not in our own, hallelujah, vices, but in the Lord. Amen. Putting on the whole armor of God. So, amen, there will be nothing that can get through our defenses because, amen, if there's anything, and anybody who's anybody that ever studied warfare, amen, praise the Lord, there's, amen, battle lines that are drawn. There's, in many cases, at least in ancient warfare, they would have, praise God, they would have a front line, a second line, amen, and in some cases, a third line, amen, hallelujah, that would battle and that would fight. And I want you to know the enemy is trying, the saints of God, he's trying to break through the defenses, amen, of the child of God. And what he's trying to attack, amen, hallelujah, is the minds of men. He's trying to get us, praise the Lord, to, amen, throw in our faith because our mind is under constant barrage of the enemy. Can the church say amen? I said I was going to try to calm down tonight. Amen. But this is what we're dealing with, saints, in the scripture. And Paul is helping us understand the difference so that we can make sure that when we get ourselves in these predicaments and situations, amen, that in many cases have nothing to do, amen, necessarily than what we even have done. It's just because life happens, amen, hallelujah. We got to know how to fight, praise the Lord. We got to know how to gird renewings of our mind with truth. We got to learn how to take the word of God and let it saturate, praise the Lord, our thinking process. We have to spiritually, thank you, Holy Ghost, put on, amen, that mirror that protects our mind, amen, that protects our thinking process, our paradigm, praise the Lord, so that we would shift the way we think. Amen. Can the church say praise the Lord? And this, I think this is important for the church to get, because the enemy is trying to attack us from the top down. He's trying to find some type of way to get in, thank God, into our defenses. So Paul, amen, is encouraging the church at Ephesus. He's telling them, don't you be confident in your ability, because your ability does not give you, thank God, hallelujah, the ability to, amen, be able to overcome the devil. Amen, hallelujah, my power, amen, my thinking, praise the Lord, amen, is not is what's going to help me, hallelujah, to be able to overcome a spirit, amen, that is warring against our mind. We are going to have to put our confidence in God. We are going to have to say, Lord, if you said it, I believe it. Hallelujah. Amen. I may not be able to know the ins and outs of it. Amen. But I believe the word of God. I trust you. Amen. Hallelujah. Don't we sing the song, if you trust. Thank God and never doubt, the Lord will surely bring you out. Amen. So Paul is telling the church. Thank God at Ephesus, finally, brethren, as he closes this book to them. Amen. As he closes the address that he's given to the church. He's saying, finally, brethren, if anything that you get out of what I've written to you in this short little book, he says, finally, brethren, hallelujah, be strong. Amen. God is not looking for weak people. He's looking for people who know how to lean on him. Hey, saints of God, hallelujah, we got to lean on Jesus today. When you look around in the world, you see a many, many problems, hallelujah, and everybody seems to think that they have, amen, everything figured out. Well, my question to them is, if you have everything figured out, why are you in the condition that you're in right now? If you know, amen, the end from the beginning, if you got everything, thank God, figured out, why are you still struggling with the same problem day in and day out? Amen. You know why? Praise the Lord. Because, amen, Sister Delph, is not in a man to direct his own steps, but the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. Amen. So Paul writes here, and he says, as I conclude this little message, amen, hallelujah, the church at Ephesus, you got to gird up the loins of your mind. Hallelujah. You got to understand the, amen, times that you are in. Amen. A lot of preachers are talking about, thank God, revival is going to happen in the land. But I stopped by to tell us revival's already happened. Amen. The time that we are in today, thank God, saints, is a time, hallelujah, preparation. It's a time for us to gird up the loins of our mind. It's a time for us to be able to stand against the wiles of the enemy that come in. Amen. He's coming in droves nowadays, saints. He's trying to tell us, hallelujah, get out the church. He's trying to tell us to walk away from our faith. He's trying to tell us that God is no longer concerned, amen, about the welfare, the everyday lives of his children. But I stop by to say, the devil is a liar, and the truth is not in him. Every day that you wake up, amen, as Jeremiah said in one place, we are waking up, saints, to a new mercy. We are waking up, thank you, Holy Ghost, to something. Thank God that the Lord is trying to show us. He's trying to show us that he's concerned about us. He's trying to show us that we belong to him. Do you hear what I'm trying to say? So, amen, we got to learn how to finally, after all, hallelujah, this stand for Jesus, stand for him. Amen, stand for him. Amen. When people are tucking their tail up, thank God, and running away from the battle. I heard Paul tell Timothy, he said, endure hardness as a good soldier.
Hallelujah. For Jesus Christ, what are you trying to say? I'm trying to say the fight is on, saints. The fight is on. Hallelujah. Amen. The enemy, hallelujah, is coming. Trying to steal, kill, and destroy. He's trying to get us to be depressed and down. He's trying to get us, amen, to retract ourselves. He's trying to get us, amen, to say nothing to that apostolic walk. Ain't nothing to living right, ain't nothing to living holy. Amen. He's trying to tell us, elder, thank you, Holy Ghost. Amen. What is the hope of his coming? For after the fathers fell asleep, all things have continued. Amen. Like they've always done. But I stopped by to tell us, amen, hallelujah, the fight is on, saints. Amen. The fight is on. And just as the garments, thank God the high priest had to be worn. Thank God in the service of the Lord. The same way, saints, we have to put on our garments and fight. Amen. Hallelujah. We got to have our hallelujah mind girded about with truth. We got to have our blessed prayed on. Hallelujah. We got to have our feet shod with the preparation. Thank God of the gospel of Jesus Christ. We got to walk through the word of God. We got to see. Thank God through the word of God. We got to have the shield of faith today. Amen. Hallelujah. Because the devil's shooting at us. Amen. He's trying to get us. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Amen. To put our defenses down. Amen. And that's how the enemy works. He works so shrewdly. Thank God around the corners. Hallelujah. He doesn't come, thank you, Jesus, when we're strong, but he comes, amen, trying to see if there's a breach in the wall, if there's a crack in our faith, amen, if there's something he can exploit us with, hallelujah. But I come to tell us, saints, hold on to Jesus, amen, hallelujah. When doubt comes, when fear comes your way, the Bible said, hallelujah, amen, be strong in the Lord, and in the power of his might. Isn't that what God told our brother? Hallelujah. He told him in one place. He says, be of good courage, and the Lord shall strengthen thine heart. Amen. What that means, being of good courage, that means in the face of an obstacle, you do not allow yourself, thank God, to be afraid. For God has not given us, thank God, the spirit of fear, but a power, love, and of a sound mind. The Holy Ghost ain't afraid of nobody. Amen. The Holy Ghost ain't afraid of nothing. Greater is he that is in you, thank God, than he that is in the world. When the Holy Ghost comes in, saints, it'll give you boldness. Praise the Lord. I'm reminded of a story in your Bible of a man by the name of Peter and John. The Bible said they came in contact with a man that, hallelujah, was impotent, or he was crippled from his mother's womb. And the Bible said the man asked alms of him, and hallelujah, Peter and John, they got fastened their eyes upon them, upon the man, and he said, silver and gold, thank God, have I none, but such as I have, give I unto thee in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise and walk. But that is really not the crux of the matter. Amen. Then they took him. Hallelujah. They took John and Peter, and they threw them in the prison and threatened them, and told them, don't you preach in the name. Amen. Hallelujah. Don't you talk about Jesus. Amen. The Bible sent Peter, being full of the Holy Ghost. Thank God, in one place. What was Peter doing? He was girded about with truth. His mind, hallelujah, had been shod. Hallelujah. Feet had been shod with the preparation of the gospel. He wasn't afraid of nobody. And the Bible said, saints, that he told them, I would rather obey God than man. I wonder sometimes when the devil tries to get us and all of his imps, thank God, to throw in the towel. We are going to end this hour, say, I would rather obey God than man. I would rather hold on to my faith. I would rather say I love Jesus, thank God, than anything anything else. Amen. It's real today. I come to tell you the fight is on. The fight for your faith is on. Amen. We got all these crazy, thank God, television shows trying to tell us how to live our lives. Trying to tell us, thank God, how to get things fixed. But I stop by the same. They don't know what they're talking about. Amen. But Brother Josh, I know a man that they called Jesus. Amen. He reached down in his toolbox. Thank God, one day and started fixing up my life. I had fell down. I was broken. Amen. Didn't nobody want to deal with me. I was in a field and my neighbor wasn't cut. My joints were, I hope you understand what I'm saying. My joints wasn't supple. Wasn't nobody concerned about me, but I could stop by to tell us. Hallelujah. One day God, he covered my mind. Hallelujah. That's what, hallelujah, Paul is trying to tell the church. Thank God at Ephesus, you got to fight. And you got to stop being afraid. You got to stop doubting God. He's never failed me yet. Amen. He won't fail us saints. If he's never failed, ain't no need to doubt him now. The Bible said he was full of the Spirit. He had the Holy Ghost talking through him. He had holy boldness. He believed the word of God. People don't believe God anymore, saints. People don't believe what God says. Thank God what he means what he says. That's the problem we're facing, is that people, hallelujah, will hear the gospel preach. They'll hear Jesus saves. They'll hear, praise the Lord, the power of truth. Hallelujah. And they'll look at the word of God, saints, and they'll walk out, hallelujah, in the same condition that they were in. But I stop by this tonight to tell us we got to, hallelujah, finally come to a place where we put on the whole, thank God, armor of God, not part of it. Hallelujah, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Saints, he don't fight fair. He's dirty. He's no good. He's evil, praise the Lord. But I stop by the same thing. He can't get through God's defenses. Amen. God's so high, he can't get over him. God's so low that he can't get under him. God is so wide that he can't get around him. Hallelujah. I don't know about you. Amen. But I believe the word of God. I believe he can do it. Amen. But we got to fight, saints. We can't be afraid today. We can't be scared. We can't get tuck our tail and run. You stay in the church. Walk with God. It's going to be all right. I got to stop. Amen. Walk with God. He'll make it turn out all right. You may not understand why. Thank God these things are happening. Hallelujah. Why am I going through? Why I'm so confused? Hallelujah. Then he goes on to tell us we ought to pray always. If you're confused, start praying. If you're confused, start fasting. Hallelujah. If you're hurting, get on your knees and say, Lord, I need some help. I need you to talk to me. Amen. I don't know what to do. Hallelujah. I come to tell us sometime the enemy, he'll try to make you go crazy. He'll try to tell you something wrong with you. You're too this or too that. Look unto Jesus and you will make it. Look unto him tonight. Look unto the hills. You see, the problem, we gotta stop looking at ourselves. We gotta stop looking at the preacher. We gotta stop looking at folk and start looking at Jesus, because he's the only one. He is the only one. Let him have his way till the day is done. He'll make it turn out all right, saints, if you hold out and never doubt it. That's what he's telling you. The church at Ephesus, hold on. You gonna be all right. Hold on. It's gonna be all right. Get your mind right. Get your hallelujah. Get your spirit right. Let the Holy Spirit give you an unction. Let him talk to you. You will make it out of the battle. I gotta stop tonight. I'm not going to try to, hallelujah, I'm trying not to preach too hard. This is the problem that we are facing today. I just want to talk to us, thank God, for a few minutes, because we have a battle. We have a fight on today. Then he goes on to say in verse 12, he said, for we wrestle not, thank God, against flesh and blood. That brings me to my next point. The battle that we are in is not a natural battle. Even though we're looking at many times natural things, but the battle that we are in, saints, is spiritual warfare. And you cannot fight, thank God, a spiritual enemy, thank God, with natural resources. We can't fight the devil. We can't fight evil spirits. Hallelujah, hallelujah, with natural things. So Paul is saying, look at what I'm trying to tell you. You got to fight them like you're fighting a spiritual enemy. You got to fight them, hallelujah, like you're fighting a battle. Amen. Against principalities, against rulers of darkness, thank God, in high places. Hallelujah. So you gotta have your garments on to fight. You gotta be prayed up. You gotta have the word, thank God, covering your mind. You gotta have, hallelujah, all of your garments on, because the enemy's shooting at you. Folk talking about you. Don't you worry about it. Did nobody die for you but Jesus, honey? Did nobody call you out but Jesus? And if God be for us, who can be against us? I stop by to tell us, it's praying time, saints. It's praying time tonight. It's time to pray like you've never prayed before. I come to tell us, talking tonight, saints, it's time to hold on. I don't know, hallelujah, when he's coming, but he's on the way, saints. And when he comes, he wants somebody, amen, that's in the army of the Lord. He wants somebody that's really fighting for Jesus. He wants somebody that got their mind made up. He wants somebody that ain't afraid to sing, I belong to Jesus, and Jesus belongs to me. Now, of time alone, throughout eternity, I'm over here to stay till the day I die. If I die, the army of the Lord, if I gotta go out fighting, go out fighting. If I gotta go out, I'll go out talking about them. Y'all don't hear me? He said, get yourself together, get your mind together, get your heart together, get your spirit together. The devil is trying to take us out. Don't let the devil talk to your mind no longer. Say, I will do what I need to do to make it.
I'm gonna stop tonight. People, hallelujah. You can switch me over. I told you, I'm gonna be good.
Die, saints, for what we believe. They died in faith, not receiving the promise. And I'm watching in our day people afraid to take that step, afraid to just say, Lord, I'm not going to worry about things that are out of my control. I'm just going to walk with God. Can the church say amen? I'm going to have tough skin, because a soldier has to be battle hardened. Soldiers are not easily persuaded to turn back. They actually call it in the army, they call it mutiny. When you abandon your post, it's mutiny. They call it AWOL. And whenever they find somebody that's went AWOL, they give them a dishonorable discharge. So Paul is telling the church at Ephesus, you better fight. But you got some tools to fight with. Yes. Saints, we got tools to fight. And the tools that we have, the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. Come on. Well. But they are mighty through God. Yeah.
to the pulling down of strongholds. These are weapons that we have at our disposal. We're not shooting bazookas. We don't have AR-15s, AK-47s, 9mm. You understand what I'm saying? But we do have weapons to fight against what the enemy is doing. So the first attack that the enemy brings in is the attack against truth. He tries to get us to disbelieve God. God is talking to us. God is speaking to our mind. And the enemy is trying to get us to disbelieve him. So we got to have our helmet of salvation. It's trying to get to our heart. I'm using this as an example now. I know your heart is your mind, but he's trying to get in. So we got to have the breastplate of what? Righteousness. See, what Paul is equating in this text is the spiritual application of the priestly garments and the fulfillment in the church. Praise the Lord. What they could not do in that it was weak through the flesh. God sent his own son in the life. But after the Spirit. Because we have the Spirit, we're able to apply these things to our life. So when the enemy is trying to get wrong with us, we can say, Lord, you told me to fight. You told me I'm a conqueror. You told me I can make it. You told me if I hold out and never doubt, you will bring me out. All I gotta do is hold on to your word. No matter what I feel like. God don't care about our feelings. He cares about his word. Can the church say amen? Amen. But if I believe him, amen, he will show up. He won't show up, saints, a minute too early. And he won't show up. But why? Because that's just how he works. So Paul is saying, finally, put things on. Because you're not wrestling against flesh and blood. But look at what he says in verse 12. Bring that up for me, Nick. Thank you, son. I'm getting older. I can call somebody son now. So he says here, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood. We're seeing basically what he's saying. In this sense, we're not wrestling with bodies. That's not our fight. You hear what I'm saying? But against principalities, against powers, against rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Our fight, like I've said before, our fight is not with one another. Our fight is with the devil and the spirits that have attached themselves to him in the world, that in many cases try to infiltrate and fight against us. That's the fight. And the only way that you can win in that fight, you have to put down your natural arms and you got to pick up spiritual warfare artillery, if you please. You got to pray. You got to fast. You got to study. You got to read. You got to have your mind in tune with God and fight against what the devil's trying to do. You hear what I'm trying to say? This is the last address that he makes to them. This is basically the conclusion of his message to them in this book. In the church, say amen. It is in this book that he gives them the seven spiritual blessings. It is in this book that he lets them know that ye are saved by grace and that not of yourself. It is in this book that he tells them that we are his workmanship in Christ. It is in this book that he tells us that we sit in heavenly places in Christ. It is in this book, saints, that he lets us know that we got to fight. I was going to preach something else today. But God wants us to fight. And the Bible said we are not ignorant of Satan's devices. The ministry is not ignorant of it. That's the reason why we have to be warned at times. Because what the enemy wants to do is run us away from him. Never run away from your help, run to it.
Amen.
Never run out, run into the fold. Don't run out of the fold. Because sheep naturally are made in which they have no defenses. They have nothing to defend themselves. And somebody say there is strength in numbers. So the Bible said he maketh his family like a flock. He gathered the lambs in one place gently with his arm, leadeth those in his bosom. Stay within the place where God can gird you up. In the 10th chapter, I believe it is, of the book of St. John, he tells us in one place, Jesus, as he addresses his disciples and those, of course, that were there, what have you, he tells them that no man can pluck you out of his hands. If we are in the hands of God, Sister Delpha, nobody can get us out. I'm in the hands of God tonight. I'm in the bosom of the Father. And I ain't going nowhere. We have to be over here to stay. Can the church say amen? The Bible said that we're bought with the price and we're not our own. Hallelujah. I don't belong to me anymore. The church say amen. What is the motto of the world? It's your thing. Do what you want to do. Y'all remember that song before y'all was sanctified? We sanctified now, though, praise the Lord. So we're not listening to It's Your Thing anymore. We listen to Have a Little Talk with Jesus, right? At least we shouldn't be, praise the Lord. But in any case, it's not my thing. I can't do what I want to do. Can the church say amen? It's not Burger King and I can't have it in my way. But I have to gird up the loins of my mind with truth. I have to put on my garments. Because the enemy's trying to break Brother and Sister Edwards through my defenses. He's trying to get in. He's trying to find a way through the back door. And then destroy my mind. And the Bible said he's the accuser of the brethren. Who's the brethren? The church. Where's he accusing us at? In your mind. He's accusing your mind. He's talking. He's trying to talk to people's mind and saying, why are you keep walking with God? What's wrong with you? Don't nobody love you? Brothers and sisters, Jesus loves us. He's trying to talk to your mind. You hear what I'm telling you? That's how the enemy works. He works through trying to get a control of our psyche. But we have to gird up the loins of our mind with what? Truth. What is going to combat the spirit of the enemy talking to our mind? The truth. So when the enemy comes and tries to talk, you tell him what the Bible said. I don't feel like it. Just tell them what the Bible said. If you tell them what the Bible said, after a while, you start feeling like telling them. Hello, somebody.
Hello.
Praise the Lord. There's a lot of things that we don't feel like doing. Can I just talk for a few minutes? I'm going to let you go. It's a lot of things that I don't feel like doing. When I was working for Riverside and Taylor Electric and had to get up 3:30 sometime in the morning and drive clear across the state. In a snowstorm, I was hoping that they canceled the job. But if they did, when you get up and go to your job, we don't do it based upon what we feel. We do it, Sister Garda, based upon what we got. Same thing goes in the spiritual. When things come our way, we got to just do it. But we have an internal struggle that Paul talked about in one place. We have the flesh warring against the spirit. The spirit against the flesh. And these two are contrary. The Spirit is telling us to stick in the fight. The Spirit is telling us to pray fast. The Spirit is telling us to gird up the loins of your mind with truth. But the flesh is telling us, no, just take a day off. Can the church say amen? It's telling us, no, it don't take all that. Call somebody and try to get them to feel what you're feeling. Misery loves company, brothers and sisters. Praise the Lord. You ever met somebody, they're always calling you up when they're miserable? And then you get off the phone and you feel just like they feel. You was doing good before you picked up the phone. But when you picked up the phone, you got what they got. You hear what I'm telling you? So let's just hold to him and fight. Sometimes your battle is your battle. It ain't nobody else's battle. It's your battle. It's your burden. Must Jesus bear the cross alone and all the world go free? There's a cross for everyone, and there's a cross for you and for me. And that's a part of the journey of the child of God. The natural battle that they have to bear. But the scripture said, underneath are the everlasting arms. When I pick up my cross, I can cast. I feel like talking. Y'all gonna let me talk for a minute? I can cast my cares upon him. For he care for me. You're not in it by yourself because you have somebody that is with you. But we got to go to him in prayer. Can the church say amen? That's all a part of the spiritual maturation and the growth of the child of God. So that we be not tossed to and fro. Can the church say amen? Sometimes it's good to just know what you're dealing with before you get there. And that's the way God works sometimes. He will prepare us in the spirit before we get to the battle. But we got to take it, saints. And as I close tonight, I want you to let you know the singers can come. If you're in a battle tonight, fight. We'll pray for you tonight. I'll pray for you tonight. If you need some help fighting, we're going to pray for you tonight. If you need some help fighting, we're going to pray for you. Because you got to fight. You got to fight. We all got to fight. Bishop Combs said it like this. He says, I got to fight. So a lot of these preachers giving up. Say it's too hard. It's too difficult. All of us got to fight, saints. Every last one of us. If you need prayer tonight, if you just want somebody praying with you, come on up to the altar. We'll pray with you. We'll pray with you. Because we gotta make up our mind. To say, I'm in this thing all the way to the end. Amen. I'm in it. And I ain't going nowhere till I get what I came from. Came for. I came for. Triumphant. To get what I need from God. And I'm not moving till I get it. Sometimes you got to tell yourself, I ain't going nowhere till I get what God wants for me. I know it's mostly us here tonight, and this message was geared more for the saints. But if you want somebody to pray for you, I'll pray for you. So that you can help in your fight. You got to fight. You can fight tonight.
Are you in the Savior's bride? Come and be baptized into the body.